Hi, it's Nikki Fowler with Glitter Magazine. Hi, Jessica and Robert. How are you today?
We're pretty good, Jessica. You on?
I'm here. Yes, we're great. Well, as Robert likes to say, we're super.
Exactly. Wonderful. Well, thanks for taking time out to speak with Glitter Magazine and congrats on the show's success. Jessica, what is the main theme for this final season of Supergirl and why did you decide on that as the final theme?
The main theme for this season is power, the abuse of power, the limits of power, both within and without, from our super friends. Robert and I love to tell stories that reflect what's going on in the real world, and we feel that this is timely and also really an examination of the type of limitless power that our heroes have been granted from the beginning and the lack of checks and balances now that they're working on their own and not in the DEO. And even with the best of intentions, can there be blind spots? Are there blind spots? And who's the arbiter of, you know, what the limit is?
Nice. And Robert, how does Kara Danvers deal with her own mortality in this final season?
Well, you know, I think she's challenged with, you know, in the Phantom Zone kind of, you know, coming to terms with, is she going to get out of here? And how does she maintain hope in a place that seems hopeless? And so it kind of brings her to a much more dark, introspective place. And we get to see the challenge of that play out over the first part of the season.
Yes. And Jessica, will Kara have to do a lot of soul searching?
Absolutely, she will. She will have to do a lot of soul searching in all parts of this final season. The beginning, you know, while she's in the Phantom Zone, and then to reconcile the themes we're talking about, we really hope that this is the evolution of Kara Danvers and Kara Zor-El as a human being and as a hero, having, you know, hailing back to what we saw as a very sort of insecure, innocent character in the pilot until we reach this very authentic, integrated, powerful woman by the end of the series.
Amazing, nice. And Robert, will we see any familiar faces return for as the season plays itself out?
We are hoping to. We're still figuring all that out, but our plan is to bring back some people and characters that the fans will be excited to see.
Will Supergirl continue to speak out for issues and social justice right up to the very last episode?
Absolutely. That's one of our main focuses this season. We're doing a bunch of social justice specific episodes, and that's a thread throughout all of our storytelling, finding new ways and different ways to be an advocate for all sorts of walks of life and disenfranchised people, and until the, you know, forever Supergirl will stand up for people who need an ally.
And also part of that, just to add on to what Jessica said, is that, you know, our theme is about power, and it's you know, a part of that is how do these, our powerful superheroes try and hope to empower the people as so it's Supergirl trying to figure out and advocate for that as well, so that everyone feels empowered.
Nice. And speaking of that, Robert, for those that don't know, how is the show inclusive overall?
You know, I mean, I think we have a very diverse we have a very diverse cast and diverse characters on television that we, you know, we think it's important for the show to be representative of the world as it is. And so we try and showcase all, you know, all you know, have it reflect on our society and the people that live in it. And so we are excited that, you know, we're able to tell a lot of stories from a lot of different perspectives.
Nice. And for both of you, before Supergirl, you both co-produced on the ABC series Blood and Oil. Did that help you bounce ideas off each other, you know, having previously worked together?
The funny thing is we didn't work all, we worked together on that show, but we weren't working as a team like we are now.
But I think what Jessica was saying, we really didn't work that much together. And then as fate would have it, we both ended up on Supergirl together, and it's been a great collaboration since then.
Awesome. And you also teased that Kelly Olsen becomes a guardian this season. Can you share any insight without giving too much away of, you know, what kind of went behind that? Was it just her, you know, taking up the mantle for her brother James, as she's the original guardian of National City, or is there something more to it? Is she more powerful, or is there anything you can kind of, you know, share to that?
I think the Kelly's guardian story is very personal to Guardian, and it grows out of other things that she's doing at the time and how she can do more and be more of an advocate and for the community. And so it's a, you know, it's a very personal story for Kelly, just as it was for James, but it's unique to Kelly. Right. And she has her own, you know, she's not becoming James's guardian, she's becoming her own version of guardian.
And for both of you, how have COVID-19 restrictions impacted the series finale? Did you have to change course on how you wanted the series to end because of it, or just kind of how did it impact you overall?
I mean, it impacted us greatly. I think we've changed the way we shoot the show to make sure everybody is safe. You know, our priority is keeping our cast and crew safe. But the downtime also allowed us, once we realized it was the final season, to really step back and take the time to figure out what we wanted this season to be about and what the message of Supergirl overall we wanted to be about, beyond just hope, help, and compassion. And it allowed us kind of the time to really craft a season that we're excited about, that really completes Kara's journey and also speaks to what we want the message of the show, as Jessica said, to be about. And so we're excited about that.
Nice. And do both of you have a favorite episode that stuck out to you? And if so, why?
Gosh. There's so many. You go first, Robert.
No, I mean, there are a lot. You know, I think I'm very fond of the first one Jessica and I wrote, which was season one, which is Falling. And it was Kara dealing with the red kryptonite. But I'm also very proud of a lot of our social justice episodes and what we were able to accomplish in season four. And also we have a lot of outstanding episodes coming up this season. I'm proud of a lot. It's tough to pick a favorite.
It's hard to choose.
Yes. I can imagine. And lastly, outside of what you've already shared, is there anything else that you can tease or share of what fans can expect for the rest of the series?
I think that the first half of the season is very emotional because it's dealing with getting Kara back. And then the second half of the season, beyond a lot of the stories we already told you about, we're dealing with a villain unlike anyone they've really faced before. So we're excited about that and how the stakes get raised, by the end of the season in a very epic way.
And just that we're going back to the core principle of the series, which is family and chosen family, and how, you know, the two sisters are really in the pilot, have started as the heart of the show, and then along the way their band of best friends and chosen family have become the heart of all the stories that we're telling. So that's where our emotional focus will end the series.
Nice. Well, Jessica and Robert, thank you so much. We're looking forward to seeing the rest of the series. And, you know, thanks for taking time out to chat with us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure.
Our pleasure is ours.